So the headquarters building for the American Quarter Horse Association was already constructed, or it was under construction at that time?
Building, I think.
Okay.
Well, it just, we moved into it and everything. We built that building out there. It was a three-story building. And what we've been in out there is all on the ground floor. And it's kind of low in there. So when they put the building up, they set it up about 8 feet above the level of the ground there. And then when they got it, all the foundation, everything put in, then they came in there and burned it up. In other words, brought in, put dirt in there up to the level of the first floor of the corner horse. And then that, all that was landscaped with all types of shrubbery and plants. And they put that grass in out there. You saw it, you know, like, mm-hmm. like people get that sod.
Mm-hmm.
They came in there and laid sod down on the whole thing. And had a beautiful lawn out there. And they planted all these trees in that ground where by the building and everything. And the guy that put all that stuff in, he guaranteed it for a year. And he'd plant a tree in there, and the tree would be there all nice and pretty for a while. It'd start dying. So they have to go in there and put another tree in, another bush in. And this kept going on. I got to look at the blueprints of the building, and the blueprints had a drawing of the way the foundation was. The foundation went straight up out of the ground, you know, got down there, and the bottom, and then it showed French drain under there, which meant if any water came down, we'd go down and pour this French drain, and it hooked up to the storm sewer and just drain all that away. And I couldn't understand why the French drain wouldn't work. So, William told Mr. Michael that, Ronnie, we got a real problem underneath the building. You go down underneath that building, it's raining under there, literally. I mean, drops coming down, it's just a continuous deal of rain. And down underneath that building, it built it up so high, there's a concrete sidewalk and then all around underneath that thing. You could walk on that concrete sidewalk and you wouldn't get in the mud, but it's still muddy. And I hired a guy with a backhoe and a dump truck to come out there on the back side of the building to drill me a hole right down by the foundation, all the way to the bottom of the foundation. That French drain wasn't in there. It was in the blueprints. So I went and took that out there and I told Michael, I said, I want you to see this. I said, this is the blueprints for the building. This is what the building is supposed to be like when they built it. You can clearly see this French drain under there. It's a concrete thing. I said, there's not one down there. So, it looks to me like I'm sure you paid for that, but you didn't get it. I said, you better get that damn architect of yours down here and see what the hell's going on. And we got the architect down there, took him underneath the building, and He's hemming around. He didn't know. I said, we'll sure fix that, but he didn't know how he was going to do it. I said, Ronnie, I said, don't worry about it. I said, I'll fix it mechanically. Just don't sweat it. I'll take care of it. So I proceeded to go there on the west side of the building and put a great big intake for air over there. It's louvered and everything. Put in the wall and in the building. Put them there for the air to come into the building and go down underneath the building. Then I went over to the other side of the building and installed some two great big old fans in there. The fan blades are about 6 feet across. And I think those motors are 10 to 12 horsepower. But anyway, I could go down there with it like that. I could hit those switches and turn those fans on. And it was just a short time until all of that was dried out over there.
Hmm.
And it was an interesting place to be. Never made as much money in my life. He sure took care of me, but I took care of that, and it's a nice place.
Yes. And how did that affect the trees and the bushes?
Well,
as far as the...
They had that sod on there, top of that dirt. That dirt they brought in was like bad dirt.
Yeah.
Stacked in there. The water would come down and go through that sod. Is probably 4 inches thick or something, you know. And then when it hit that dirt down there in the bottom, the water couldn't penetrate it, so it just run off underneath that grass. And nobody could tell what was going on. I looked out there from my office one day, and here this great big huge mound. When I'm saying huge, it was probably 200 feet across and 80 feet wide. And we had stuff burned up and everything around there, but I looked at, we didn't have anything like that out there. And there it was. And I mean, it just came up, went across there, and down the sidewalk, the other side. Well, the water line had broke under there. Started just gushing that water out. So I went out there and got to look at that. And the guy's kind of the caretaker of the building there. He came out there and I said, go get me a shovel, sharpshooter. He brought that shovel out there. And I took that thing and just jammed it in there. The boil when I did, here's a stream of water came out of that thing about that big and just shot out there.
Hmm.
Under so much pressure.
All right.
And finally, it got the water leak stopped, and the grass just laid back down, and everything started going in.
Hmm.